episode 1855, A Double Dose of Love.
Moms, it's time to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew who you are in mind, body, and spirit. Welcome to Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, the show to help you do just that. Here's your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo.
Staring at a stop sign, watching people drive by.
Happy, happy day. How are you doing today? Seriously, have you thought about really how you want to feel today? Because you know what? What you think about, you bring about. It's all about relationship builders. You want to have a strong foundation in your marriage? Come on, it's all about a double dose of love. For those of you who are brand new to Create Your Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the K.I.S.S. newsletter, the Keep It Simple Strategy, Everyday Solutions to Live, Love, and Impact. Well, this episode is brought to you by the AIM Academy. It's up and coming just around the corner. I'm getting so excited. Stay tuned here on the podcast. And also, if you've signed up on the newsletter, those are the only two places you will hear about this because you need to be the first. All right, let's dive in. Can you believe next Friday, I know, mark your calendars, is Valentine's Day. Now, Valentine's Day can freak people out, especially when you're married. And it's really cute when you're dating. But then it comes to after first year, second year, things begin to shift a little bit. Life happens. Things change. And we don't realize that we lose sight as to what actually happened so many years ago. Marriage is a two-way street. You can't love your partner without loving yourself. What is needed is a double dose of love. But how do you love your spouse? And in return, how do you love yourself? These are questions we really don't answer because we make assumptions. When we look at ourselves, we think, oh, well, if I do this, I'll feel this way. Is that for the longevity of your life? Or is it, no, just for that brief moment to make me feel better? What is it? How do you love your spouse? Most people don't know that there's a lot of different ways to love. Yet we're challenged. We're challenged when our days are so busy. We're challenged when we work long, long, long days and are too tired to snuggle. We're challenged when our activities involve more of our children than that of our spouse. We don't know if we're coming or going. Our love is there, but quietly waits for attention. It's hard to give when you yourself feel dry and empty. That's what a lot of women and men say. It's on both sides. I feel like I give, but man, I've given so much that I don't have anything left. The well has run dry. I don't know what to do. So this Valentine's Day, I want you to instill a double dose of love. That is your KISS to Keep It Simple strategy. Instill a double dose of love. That double is what? For you and your spouse, right? You don't want that love well to dry up to the point of no return. So changes have to be made as to how you love yourself and how you love your spouse. So let's break it down. In order to instill that double dose of love, it starts first by showing yourself love, extending your heart to your spouse, and committing to each other. That's where you begin. So number one, showing yourself love. You've got to understand that you are not perfect. Don't try to be everything to everybody. You will never be everything to your spouse. That's just a hard knocks truth. Yet I know when we got married, looking back, I'm sure somewhere way back in my wonderful idea that I had, how marriage was supposed to look, that I truly believed that I was my everything to my husband. I would give him everything. Huh, there's no way. Yes, am I his rock? Am I his best friend? Does he come to me first? Yes, but I can't be everything. And when you look to your spouse that way, you're setting yourself up for ultimate, ultimate failure. Now, we could spend all day on this topic, so we're not going to go into it a great detail. But you've got to first show yourself love. And that, again, doesn't mean that you look at yourself as being perfect. You've got to accept that you're not. And a lot of us now, because of the day and age that we're in, we're like, oh, I know I'm not perfect. But we say it so fast. But if we look at our actions, are we actually showing that? We're not. If we're going to be real and honest, we say it, but we don't believe it. We say it, but we don't act upon it accordingly. And that's going to run you in the ground faster than anything else you do. So you've got to show yourself love. That might be when you're washing your face at night and you're doing your little nighttime regimen. Maybe you need to look at yourself in the mirror and not look for, oh man, is that gray hair there? Oh, there's that wrinkle again. I'm trying to get it less. Oh, those, 11 lines. Why are they there so deep? I've got this brow line that will not go away. Don't look at all that stuff. Look beyond that. Look into your eyes. See beyond that and tell yourself something beautiful. Say, you did great today, Mom. You looked really good in your jeans. You had so much energy today. You rocked it. Now, does that mean your day was perfect? No. Because is any day perfect? No. But you need to show yourself love. You got to start doing that. It's a double dose of love. Number two, extending your heart to your spouse. Don't hold back. If you're hurting, your spouse is too. If you miss your spouse, guess what? Most likely he's missing you. So extend your heart. Sometimes our actions fall flat because it's missing the heart. Have you ever been on the receiving end of a gift? Someone gives you something and they're like, oh, I thought of you. And they just kind of give it. And you can just tell that it's like almost like a push. Like they were trying to find just the right words to say, but it fell flat. It didn't have any sincerity to it. Our spouses, they notice that too. If we don't have our heart in it, they're going to have question marks in their heart. So you've got to extend your heart to your spouse. The actions, you may be doing everything right, but you might be leaving out the best part, and that's your heart. So don't hold back. Extend your heart to your spouse. And finally, number three, committing to each other. It's a two-way street, right? Marriages. It's not just one way, it's two-way. So you got to commit to each other. Figure a way to hang out more often. Where can you show up in the evening next to your spouse? That's what a lot of men that I speak to, they're like, oh, I just want my woman next to me. Now that just sounds awesome, right? Now some people would say, oh, well, he's trying to own her. No, he wants the companionship. He wants his woman next to him, holding hands or watching the same show. Now, you may not like that show, but if he wants your companionship, guess what? Sometimes we've got to give a little. And we're like, okay, I'll spend time. I'll just sit with you. You don't even have to have conversation. But to him, that's quality time. But you're like, wait a minute, but he's watching a TV. He's not even interacting with me. We're not having a conversation. I know, I get it. But you have to understand the way they see it. So where can you show up in the evening? Where can you show up in the morning? I show up in the morning for my husband when I bring him his cup of Joe. And his cup of Joe is Pepsi. Yeah, that's what he likes. He doesn't drink coffee. Neither do I. And that's okay. But his cup of Joe is Pepsi. So as he's getting ready, I bring him in an ice cold Pepsi. And he loves it. Now, yes, is he capable of going to get his own cup of Joe? Of course he is. But you know what? That's my extension to him that says, you know what? I'm thinking about you this morning. It's a way for me to hang out with them, if just for a few minutes, because you know what? The mornings are crazy. But those 10 seconds of saying, here, babe, I love you. That's it. You don't have to carry on anything else but that. And all of a sudden, it's like, whoa, it's a new day. This is awesome. It fills the well, the love well. You know, maybe you need date night. Now, some people say, but have you looked at my budget? Do you know how many kids we have? Do you know our activities? Your date night doesn't have to mean that you're spending money. It doesn't have to mean that you're without the kids. Yes, if you can do that, that's awesome. But I know for us, we just kept having child after child after child. And no, they weren't like real close together, but they're stair steps all the way. We've got 5 children under the age of 8 years. And it was crazy. And we had no family around us. So if my husband wasn't there, I always called myself the married single mother. That's who I was, because he was building his career, yet we had a family. And so I had to take care of the family and take care of him. It was kind of crazy. And most of the time I felt like I was doing it by myself, but I was willing to sacrifice. However, there were times that we would come together. Even with the kids around, even when we were just surrounded by Legos, all of our children love Legos to this day. Doesn't matter how old they are. They love Legos. At least right now, I don't step on them as often. Man, when they were littler, I would clean up and it's like, oh, right under the heel. And that really hurts if you haven't stepped on a Lego. I would find them everywhere. I'm talking like 10 to 12 at a time. And when you're vacuuming every day, that's a lot of Legos. So we would be surrounded by Legos building things. No, it wasn't a date night as in just the two of us, but it was us coming together as a family. That fills the love well. Making time for each other. And it doesn't have to be a huge extended period of time. If you can go out, grab a movie, that's awesome. Maybe you put the kids to bed 30 minutes earlier, just 30 minutes. One night a week, so you all can go in your own room and close the door. Maybe it's just to talk. Maybe it's to put on a 30-minute show that you enjoy and you watch it together. You watch a show on demand. Or maybe it's just snuggle time. Whatever it is, but you've got to begin to commit to each other. Hang out together. Because if you're not hanging out together, you can't grow together. So show yourself love, extend your heart to your spouse, and commit to each other. Everyone should experience a double dose of love. But just like anything, it takes work. Love doesn't happen because you wish it. Love doesn't show up because you deserve it. Love takes action on a daily basis, not just when it's convenient. So buckle down and grab a double dose of love. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a glorious weekend. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.